You may not know this, but Naturalis Biodiversity Center is not only a scientific institute, but also a museum. Right now, we're in the middle of building a new museum. However, we're also working on something else. Introducing a special guest, our director, Edwin van Huys. What's the news?
The news is that Naturalis is going to organize this blockbuster exhibition in Japan about von Siebold in 2023.
So who is von Siebold?
Von Siebold was born in 1796, studied medicine. He wanted to go to the Dutch colonies in the east and was stationed in Deshima in Japan. Now, in Deshima, he worked as a physician, but he was a scientist and he was mostly interested in nature. So he was collecting animals and plants all the time.
What is the relation between Naturalis and von Siebold?
In actually a very short time that he lived there, only for 6 years, he collected more than 22,000 objects. 200 mammals, there are 900 birds, there are 750 fish, there are 5,000 invertebrates, there are about 12,000 dried plants, and all send them to Leiden. And of course, the largest part is a naturalistic collection in Naturalis. It's not only a very big collection, but it's also scientifically a very, very strong collection. It's very important. Most of the plants were not known to anyone. Of course, we didn't know very much about Japan, but after von Siebold went there, it was one of the best described collections ever. But we still do research, and we still find new plants, animals.
Well, it sounds like an awesome collection. I hear there are some very special objects in the collection. Can you give an example?
Well, when the crates opened in 1829, everything was special, of course. It was not only dried specimens, there were also a lot of live specimens, live plants, and some of them are still alive at Hortus Botanicus. I remember he sent two giant salamanders, huge animals, and one ate the other during the journey back to Leiden, so only one arrived. If we look at the collection now, it's still very, very special. Extinct animals, like the Japanese wolf. It was a wolf in Japan. For the first time since it left Japan, it's going to go back to Japan in this exhibition, which is going to be very special.
That sounds amazing. The big question is, do the Japanese people want to know more about von Siebold?
Everybody knows von Siebold in Japan. It's something that you learn at school. In Japan, von Siebold is a rock star. You have to realize that when he came to Japan in 1823, Japan was a very different country from what it's now. Japan was totally isolated and had been for 200 years. No people were allowed in, no people were allowed out. He was the only Western scientist the Japanese had seen for 200 years. He was the gateway to the rest of the world.